Good morning students, welcome all. In today's video of the economics, we are going to study the another topic related to the elasticity of the demand. In elasticity of the demand, there is a number of factors affecting on demand. Say for example, if we take an example of price elasticity in the meat, how demand affects if the price of any commodity will increase or decrease. If we take an example of income elasticity of the demand, it means how income of any particular group affects on the demand of any commodity. If we take an example of cross elasticity of the demand, it means the price of substitute goods or alternative goods, how they affect on the demand of any commodity. And now in today's video, we are going to study how advertisement of any commodity affect on any particular thing. So, the advertising elasticity of demand. Advertising elasticity of demand means how any advertisement affects on the demand of any commodity. For example, if we take example of some big star like Amitabh Bachchan, Sachin Tendulkar, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Salman Khan, Anushka Sharma, Virat Kohli, these all type of superstar take more than crores of rupees for their advertisement. For their advertisement maybe hardly for 1 minute or 30 seconds. For 30 second advertisement or for 1 minute advertisement, this big star take 1 crore rupee or more than 1 crore rupee. How any company afford that 1 crore rupee cost only for 30 seconds advertisement? कोई पण एडवर्टाइजमेंट जे छे मोटा मोटा स्टार जे मा होय तो ये छे 30 सेकंड ना 1 करोड़ रुपया वसूल करती होय छे. व्हाई कंपनी विल रेडी टू पे दैट अमाउंट टू दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टार. हियर वी कैन गेट आंसर फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो. समटाइम्स इफ एनी बिग स्टार मेक एनी एडवर्टाइजमेंट फ्रॉम दैट एडवर्टाइजमेंट any firm, company or any firm can earn more than 1 crore rupees. For example, in any advertisement, the big star, say for example, Amitabh Bachchan takes 1 crore rupees as a fee to act in any particular, say for example, in Navratna Oil, to do that advertisement. Say for example, Amitabh Bachchan will take 1 crore rupees from the manufacturer. Manufacturer even ready to give 1 crore rupees to the Amitabh Bachchan. Why? Because the advertisement of the Amitabh Bachchan will give more than 1 crore rupees to the manufacturer. That's why manufacturer will ready to pay 1 crore rupees to the Amitabh Bachchan. So this type of elasticity how effect on any commodity, this will be studied in this video. On the page number 60, there is given advertising elasticity of the demand. Advertising plays an important role in increasing demand for sale of the firm's commodity. Hence, advertising is an important factor affecting demand. The efforts many advertising and other efforts through which the demand increases is called advertising elasticity of the demand. It means the efforts many advertisement or other factors or other efforts in the advertisement according to that factors, according to that efforts, how the advertisement affects on the demand of any commodity, this is called advertising elasticity. Say for example, if you are advertising your commodity and for that advertising you how much money you expend on that particular advertisement, it will be studied in the elasticity of the demand of advertising. On the basis of above, the meaning of advertising elasticity of demand means, here you have given the meaning of advertising elasticity. It means the ratio of a relative change in a demand to a relative change in advertising or other promotional expenses. It means if you make expenses on the advertisement or if you make advertisement of any commodity of any goods, how that expenses or how that advertising benefits in demand of any commodity, that is called the advertising demand, advertising elasticity. તમે એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ કરો તો એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટના કારણે તમને કેટલા પ્રમાણમાં માંગમાં વધારો કે ઘટાડો થાય છે અથવા કેટલો ફાયદો થાય છે એમને તમારે એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ ઇલાસ્ટિસિટી તરીકે ઓળખવામાં આવે છે. ના વોલ્યુમ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ એન્ડ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ કોસ્ટ એન્ડ ડિમાન્ડ. હિયર સેકન્ડ ઇઝ ગિવન, વોટ ઇઝ ધ રિલેશન બિટવીન cost, sorry, advertising cost and demand. It means if you make advertising or if you expense on the advertisement, how that expense will affect on the demand. Here you have given that following are the relationship between advertising cost and demand. The first is, if the factors like price, quality, etc. of the commodity are kept stable, it means there is no change in the price of the commodity, and if there is no change in the quality of that particular commodity, then it seems that there is a direct relation between advertising and sales or demand. In your book, there is a off given, there must be or. તમારે જે છે એ ડિમાન્ડ રિલેશન બિટવીન એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ ઇન કોસ્ટ એન્ડ ડિમાન્ડની અંદર ફર્સ્ટ પોઈન્ટમાં લાસ્ટ લાઈનમાં જે છે એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ એન્ડ સેલ્સ, ત્યાં ઓફ છે, ઓફના બદલે ઓર કરવાનો છે, ઓર ડિમાન્ડ. એનો મતલબ એવો થાય કે ઇટ મીન્સ ઇફ યુ આર નોટ ચેન્જિંગ ઇન યોર ક્વોલિટી, ઇફ યુ આર નોટ ચેન્જિંગ ઇન ધ પ્રાઇસ ઓફ યોર કોમોડિટી, એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ ધેર ઇઝ અ ડાયરેક્ટ રિલેશન બિટવીન એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ એન્ડ સેલ્સ ઓફ ધ ડિમાન્ડ. For example, you pay 1 crore rupee to any star, you pay 1 crore rupee in the advertisement, and you are not increase or decrease your price at all. Say for example, if you pay 1 crore rupee to any advertisement medium, for that, say for example, before advertisement your price is 10 rupees, and after advertisement also, if you will do your advertisement and according to after the advertisement given, if your price is the same like 10, it means this may most effect in your goods, in your commodity. જો તમે 10 રૂપિયા 10 જ રાખો એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ પછી પણ તમારો ભાવમાં વધારો કે ઘટાડો કરો નહીં, તો એ તમારા જે છે ડાયરેક્ટ રિલેશન છે કે directly relates to your business operations is this is directly related to your cost and demand. Without incurring any type of advertising expenses, also goods are sold to some extent. If you are not making advertising at all, at that time also your selling would be done on some extent. There is a truth in that saying that if you are making advertisement, at that time your commodity, your price, or sorry, your commodity or your goods can sell more. But if you are not making any advertisement or if you are not making any expenses on the advertisement, at that time also your goods or your commodity is sold on some extent. After that, to certain extent, increase in sales is higher than the expenditure on advertising. But after that, it tends to decrease and finally there is no increase. The third point is, if you are doing advertisement also at that time, first of all your cost is higher. After that you will get benefit which cost you incur in the advertisement. And on the third stage, in the third stage you will not get any benefit from the advertisement done by you. Let's see this concept by the diagram. Now let's see the diagram of advertising elasticity of the demand. On the page number 61, there is given the fact can be understood from the figure given here. Here you can see in this diagram, on the x axis there is a advertising cost is given. On the y axis there is a sales of any commodity is given. And this is the demand. How demand will affect if the advertising expenses is incurred on any particular commodity. So now from the figure, the sales line is SS1. This is the sales line of the commodity. It is related that certain sales can be possible even without advertising. It can be seen in the figure that OS sales is possible even without expenditure. This we seen earlier. If you are not making any advertisement on your commodity, at that time also you will get some extent of the sales. On the this time, this much sales you can do without any advertisement. Means if you are not doing any advertisement, if you are not making advertisement of your commodity at all, at that time also you will sell your product on this extent. After that, moreover, initially the rates of sales increase are higher than the rate of increase in advertisement expenses. It means initially in the initial stage, your rates of sales increase are higher than the rate of increase in advertisement expenses. For example, on this point you will start the exercise advertising. On this point you will start advertising. At that time, from end to end, you will get higher and higher sales during this period. After that, your sales will decrease day by day. આપની અંદર શરૂઆતના જોકે કોઈ પ્રકારના એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ એક્સપેન્સ કરતા નથી. એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ ઓલસો યુ વિલ ગેટ સમ એક્સટેન્ટ ઓફ ધ સેલ્સ આફ્ટર ધેટ. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, ઇફ યુ વિલ સ્ટાર્ટ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ, ઇન ધ ઇનિશિયલ સ્ટેજ ઓફ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ યુ વિલ ગેટ મોર એન્ડ મોર ગુડ્સ સોલ્ડ ઓફ યોર કોમોડિટી. શરૂઆતના સ્ટેજમાં તમે જે છે વધારે એને સેલ કરી શકશો, તમારું સેલિંગ વધશે. આફ્ટર ધેટ યોર સેલ્સ વિલ બીકમ્સ ડિક્રીઝિંગ ડે બાય ડે. હિયર યુ કેન સી આફ્ટર ધેટ યોર સેલ્સ વિલ બીકમ ઇનફ ડિક્રીઝિંગ. લેટર ઓન ઇટ ટેન્ડ્સ ટુ ડિક્રીઝ એન્ડ અલ્ટિમેટલી ધ રેટ ઓફ સેલ્સ ઇન્ક્રીઝ રીચ ઇઝ ઝીરો. યોર સેલ્સ, the amount of the sales will decreasing day by day, and after that your sales will, the amount of the sales will become zero. The advertisement cost will not benefit at all. After the advertising to the extent of OM, the rate of sales increase becomes zero. OM. After that your expenses of advertisement becomes zero. It means if we see this diagram in the simple manner, then say for example, if any commodity of your enterprise, if any goods of your enterprise does not make any advertisement, at that time also you will get some selling. This is shown on OS. After that, for example, if you will think your, if you will advertisement of your commodity, the advertisement of that commodity will give you more profit, more selling. So you will start advertisement of your your cost will higher, and in initial stage your selling will also higher. After that, continuously your advertisement gives you the more and more result. Once you incur expenses on the advertisement, after that you don't need to expense on that advertisement again. But that advertisement gives benefit of sales increment continuously, and this continuously sales increment ultimately becomes zero of the expenses which you incur on the advertisement. So ultimately the advertisement of any commodity gives you the more and more benefit. This will be seen on this diagram on the page number 62. There is a factor affecting advertising elasticity of demand. In that, the first is given level of advertising expenditure. The third is given factors that affects on the advertising elasticity of the demand. In that, the first is given level of advertising expenditure. In the level of advertising expenditure and different media can be included. Higher the level of advertising expenditure of the firm than the competitor firm's expenditure, higher its sales will be to the extent. That means if the level of advertising expenditure is higher, the more is advertising elasticity of demand. It means as much as you expense on the advertisement, as much as you will get the benefit of the advertisement. For example, if you are advertising on the small level, at that time you will get that type of the benefit. If you will advertise by the hoarding on the big cities, on the main roads, if you will hoardings of your commodity, it will give you the more benefit than the earlier. And if you advertise your commodity on the television, this will give you the more benefit. It means whatever the type of your advertising media or whatever the expenses you incur on advertising, is higher the expenses of advertising, higher the extra benefit of the advertising. The next is given condition of development of a commodities market. Condition of development of the commodities market. Advertising elasticity of demand for new commodities seems high, while elasticity of demand of old or famous commodity is lower. That means considerable sales increase can be achieved with the help of advertising expenditure for the new product. If your product is just in introductory stage, at that time you will get more benefit of the advertising. Here you can take example of Zomato. Zomato company is a very new in the market. He continuously expenditure on the advertising media. Whenever you will start the YouTube, all the time you have advertisement of Zomato. Yeah, YouTube open, there come up the money. નીચે એ ઝોમેટોની એ આવે છે ઓર ઇફ યુ વિલ ઇફ યુ હેવ સ્ટાર્ટ એની સોશિયલ મીડિયા ઇન ઓલ સોશિયલ મીડિયા યુ હેવ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ ઓફ ઝોમેટો સો ઝોમેટો ઇઝ અ ન્યુ કંપની હી એક્સપેન્સિસ મચ ઇન મચ ઓન ધ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ સો નાઉ ઝોમેટો બીકમ વન ઓફ ધ બિગેસ્ટ કંપની ઇન ધ એરિયા વાય બીકોઝ હી taken into consideration he gives more attention on the advertising if your company or if your product is good at that time if you will attention on the advertisement this will gives you the more benefit but if your product or if your commodity is old at that time if you will incur expenses of advertisement on old product the old product will not give you that much benefit now reaction of competitors what is the reaction of your advertisement effects on the reaction of the competitive firms if a certain firm pay for advertising its commodity and as a reaction for to it if competitor firms also spend substantially on advertising then the advertising elasticity of demand remains low it means if you are incur expenses on the advertisement your competitor firm also incur some expenditure on the particular commodity to follow you at that time you will get less benefit of your advertisement but if siyara mein kya hai ki jo sakare koi seasonal vastu hai on the seasonal thing if one advertisement is started behind that all the other substitute products advertisement will start કોઈ એક જેસે મારા ડર્મી કોઈ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ તો એની પાછળ બીજી કોઈ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ પણ સ્ટાર્ટ થાય છે ઇફ વન કંપની સ્ટાર્ટેડ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ ઓફ ધેટ પ્રોડક્ટ બિહાઇન્ડ ધેટ તો અધર કંપની ઓલસો સ્ટાર્ટ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ ધેટ પ્રોડક્ટ સો ઇફ બોથ ધ કંપની સ્ટાર્ટેડ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ ઓફ ધેટ પ્રોડક્ટ ઇન અ સર્ક્યુલર ઓર્ડર એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ યુ વિલ ગેટ લેસ બેનિફિટ ઓફ ધ એડવર્ટાઇઝિંગ કોસ્ટ The fourth is effect of non-advertising factors. Effect of non-advertising factors. How much is the effect of non-advertising factors like price, income, price of alternative commodity, etc. on the sales? Also play a major role in determining advertising elasticity of demand. If these factors largely affect the sales, then the factors of advertising expenditure will not be so effective in increasing sales that means the advertising elasticity of demand will remain very low it means whatever expenses you incur on the advertisement on the other hand if there is any non advertising factors which can affect on the demand of your commodity say for example if the price of your commodity is 10 say for example the price of your commodity is 10 after advertisement cost and the price of your competitor commodity is also same without any advertisement cost say for example the cost of both the goods here you incur expenses on the advertisement and your cost is 9 you will get 10% in profit here and the cost of your competitor firm is 8.5 they are not making any expenses on the advertising media so the cost of your competitor firm will 8.5 and then if your competitor and your both the price is 10 rupees there are number of customers are available in the market who prefer your competitor's product rather than your product so if this type of product or this type of commodities are available in the market this type of situations are available in the market at that time there is a strong possibility your will not get that much benefit of the advertising expenses you incur on that particular product. Here, they have given if these factors largely affects the sales, if the price of alternative commodity, if the income of the other person, this all affects on your sales largely, then the factor of advertising expenditure will not be so effective in increasing sales. At that time, there may be happen that your expenses on the advertisement will not be that much effective. That means the advertising elasticity of demand will remain very low. It means the advertising elasticity of the demand will remain very low. After that, the fifth and last point, that is time factor. Advertising expenditure has effects on sales, but there is no specific time limit as to when that effect will take place. When there will be increase in sales due to advertising expenditure is independent on the nature of the commodity. It means if you are making advertisement, but that advertisement when it gives you benefit, it is not clear, it is not final. But there is no specific time limit as to when that effect will take place. If you are advertising your commodity, if you are advertising your goods, that advertisement surely gives you benefit. But where, when, how that particular benefit will you get? This is not final. When there will be increase in sales due to advertising expenditure is independent on the nature of the commodity, the extent of advertising expenditure, choice of customer, etc. It means if the choice of the customer will stable and after that if the choice of the customer will choice of the customer will different, at that time also you will not get the benefit of your advertising. Here we can take example of Ambuja Cement. Before many years, one Ambuja Cement's advertisement came, but at that time, very few persons are there who taken into consideration the advertisement of Ambuja Cement. After few years passed, after that, the advertisement of the Ambuja Cement get consideration, get attention from the customer. So this is the time factor. It may be happen that if your company do advertisement expenses on any commodity, at that time your commodity or your goods not get that much attention from the customers. And once your time is going, or after some time your attention, you will get the attention from the customers. If the effect of past advertising expenditure takes place on present sales, if the effects of present advertising expenditure takes place in future sales, then it becomes difficult to measure the advertising elasticity of the demand. This is also important. Here they have given that if the effects of past advertising expenditure takes place on the present sales, it means whatever you have incurred expenses on the past, and that expenses effect in the present time, in the today time, and the effect of present advertising expenditure takes place in the future sales, then it becomes difficult to measure the advertising elasticity of the demand. It means, say for example, if you are incurring expenses on the advertisement, you are thinking that this advertising expenses will give you benefit in the recent time only, in the current time only. But there may be happen if you are making expenses on the advertisement in the present time, at that time you will not get that much benefit, but after some time you will get some benefit. And on the other hand, it may also happen that today, in the current time, if you are making expenses on the advertisement and you will not get the benefit of the advertisement recently, but after some years passed, you will get the benefit of your advertisement. So this could be happen in the business organization. So these are the basic factors related to the advertising elasticity of the demand. The first is level of advertising expenditure. How much you expend? What is your expenditure on the advertising? That is effect on the advertising elasticity of the demand. The condition of development of the commodities market. How your competitive firm effect on the commodity of the demand. The third is reaction of competitive firm. How your competitive firm react on your advertisement, that also effect. The fourth is effect of non-advertising factors. If there is any non-advertising effect, non-advertising factors are there who effect on the demand of the commodity, how that effect on the elasticity of the advertising of any commodity. And the five is the time factor, how time factor is effect on the advertising elasticity of the demand. So this is all about the advertising elasticity of the demand. In our next video, we are going to start our new topic. Thank you.